simple question today, so this should be a very short video. Are teachers biased when awarding grades? Yes. And yet I'm managing to talk about it for a lot longer than just yes, because this is quite a complicated subject. So if you want to learn more, then keep watching. Hello lovelies, it is May, but it is freezing and rainy and horrible out there, which is really not what we need at the moment. We need nice sunshine and happy things to cope with the fact that centre assessed grades are being decided at the moment. Chances are, if you're in year 11 or year 13, you've spent the past few weeks sitting lots and lots of exams. These will probably be marked over half term, and then by the middle of June, teachers' centres will have to submit those grades to the exam boards to be checked. Now, last year, when this happened, obviously, I put out a video saying basically the same question: are teachers biased in awarding grades? And the answer then was also yes, but in that video, I talked about how teachers are biased based on gender, how they're based on race, and how they're biased based on socioeconomic status. And that got me in a lot of trouble. So that is not what we're going to be talking about this time, because I upset a lot of people in that video. I don't want to upset a lot of people. So this time we are just going to be looking at the way that Ofqual think that teachers are biased. Now, I'm not trying to do down your teachers in any way, or if you're a teacher watching this, I'm not trying to be mean, not trying to upset you, but I'm talking about when you look at a book and decide whether you're going to want to read it or not, or whether you look at a bit of cake and you pick one. We all have previous life experiences, we all have stuff going on. It means that when we make a decision, it is not going to be completely unclouded by any other judgment. Which is why when exams get marked, the person marking it does not know who wrote it. They do not know the name of the person who wrote it. So they cannot make a guess at the gender of the person. They cannot make a guess of the background of the person. So there is no bias coming across in their marking. And this has been evidenced lots. Anyone that's doing A-level psychology will tell you lots and lots of stuff about bias. But Ofqual have released a document a few weeks ago now with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 different ways that teachers can be biased. And the point of this is to make teachers aware of their inherent bias that everybody has, so that they can try and overcome this bias when awarding grades, because if you are more aware of something, then you can try and overcome it. Now, teachers aren't just going to be using one bit of evidence to decide your grades, they're going to be using lots of different bits of evidence, so don't try and worry yourself too much about this. So if we have a look at the list that was released, we have confirmation bias. For example, noticing only evidence about a student that fits with pre-existing views about them. So, if a student gets a 5 on a paper and they've already got 5s, then you might be more likely to pay attention to the 5 than the 7 they got on a previous bit of homework. Or, taking it from the other example, if a student has done 4 tests, then they're a 5, a 5, a 7, and a 5, but they've got 7s or previously, a teacher might be more likely to give more weight to that 7, the one that fits with the pattern previously, than just basing it on the 4 assessments that they've done recently. Halo effects. For example, where a particularly positive impression of a student overly accentuates their actual knowledge, skills or abilities, or the opposite, where a negative impression or low expectation of a student hides their actual skills and abilities. So there are lots of different things this could be related to. If you have a particularly like well-dressed, well-spoken, very polite student, somebody might assume that they're going to get better grades than the person that always turns up late and looks harassed and never has their shirt tucked in, never has their blazer on. Something like that, where because they look like they should do good, the teacher would assume that they do good, or at least have better grammar than I do. Primacy effects. For example, giving undue weight to first impressions of a student. So first impressions here do count for a lot. They are saying that the first impression might be the one that sticks. So if you made a good first impression, great, but if you didn't make a good first impression, well, that might still affect the grade that your teacher gives you months, years later. Recency effects. For example, giving undue weight to the most recent interaction with a student. Now, you've just come back from a period of homeschooling, from a period of being at home. If that was a really, really traumatic period for you, then chances are you haven't come back into school in the right frame of mind, being the best that you can possibly be. And if that is the interaction that the teacher is having with you at the moment, then it might not be to your benefit. They might just see that and not take into account everything that's gone before. Selective perceptions. For example, giving undue weight to a student's performance on a particular piece of work. So teachers are going to be taking into account a range of different types of evidence. But if there's one bit that a teacher particularly favours over another bit, they might give a bit more weight to that instead of taking everything fairly into account. Contrast effects. For example, overestimating a student's likely performance, having first considered a large number of students who are all at a much lower standard. For example, if you've marked a load of papers that were all at a grade 2 or a grade 3 standard, and then you come across a one that is a grade 5 standard, sometimes the relief of realising that somebody actually gets what you've been teaching them can lead to grading more generously, because you're happy that somebody gets it. So that person's performance might actually be boosted, maybe unfairly. They might get a higher grade than they would have done if the previous work before them had been a grade 7 or a grade 8 level. They might not get the exact grade they deserve. Exception effects. For example, over or undergrading a student's performance if it is significantly out of line above or below other students in that centre. So if you've got one student that you know is very, very good or very, very weak in a particular subject, and the rest of the class is lying around the middle, then that student might get bumped up or bumped down because they are the outlier. Conformity bias. For example, placing undue weight on the opinions of others where they're not necessarily supported by the evidence. Now, it is not just going to be one single teacher submitting evidence to this, especially in subjects like science where you might have 3 teachers or 6 teachers, or it could be 6 teachers and a head of department or the exams officer as well, all in this. If one of those people has a particularly positive or particularly negative impression of a student, then they can have an influence on the others. This is a thing that we see really, really often in juries, where somebody tries to persuade everyone around to see their point of view. Affinity bias. Having a more favourable impression of a student's performance because the student's or their qualities or attributes are relatable or similar to one's own qualities or attributes. So if a teacher sees something in you that they like, that is similar to them, they might be more inclined to give you a better grade. And this opposite is also true, that if there's something different about the student to the person grading them, then that might not work in their favour. So that is what has been said, guys. Hopefully I'm not going to get in too much trouble with this one like I did last year, because I am just reading out to you what was put out by the exam board. So all teachers should have seen this, all teachers should have read this, or at least be aware of this and be taking this into account when they are grading. It's not something you should worry about too much, because your teachers honestly want the best for you. So they're not deliberately going to put you down just to be spiteful, because that's not what teachers do. We are nearly at the end, guys. We can do this. We can do it together. So good luck, guys. I'm going to hear the every single step of the way. Ouch! This is why in some videos I have unexplained scratches.